With Proactive at the ASX Smaller Midcap Conference 2020, I'm joined by Chris Behrenbruch from Telix Pharmaceuticals. Chris, good to meet you.
Hi, Andrew. Thanks for your time.
Tell us a bit more, Chris. What's your particular focus at Telix?
So we specialize, we're a pharmaceutical company that specializes in what's called molecularly targeted radiation. And so the basics of it are we develop drugs that carry a radioactive payload. And when you inject that drug into your body, it whizzes around until it finds a cancer cell and attaches to it. And then it delivers that radiation to the cancer cell in a very targeted way. And this is novel because, you know, traditionally when we treat patients with cancer with radiation, we use a big box that sits in the basement of a hospital. We shoot x-rays at the patient. And that's how we deliver radiation, which is, you know, I think most people would know is a very common part of cancer care. But this is much more targeted. Doesn't cause so much collateral tissue damage, and it allows you to treat very, very small metastases that you can't see in an image. So it's much more systemic. And if you deliver a small dose, you can put a patient in a thing called a positron emission tomography or a PET scanner, and you get a gorgeous image from your toes to your nose, everywhere where the disease is. And if we then woof up the dose by about 1,000 times, we then treat the patient's disease using the same mechanism.
And your lead program is looking at prostate cancer.
Yeah, so we have three disease focus areas, prostate cancer, renal cancer, and a very aggressive type of brain cancer called glioblastoma. But the prostate cancer program is the farthest ahead. Our imaging agent is just going through marketing authorizations right now in Europe, and we're just about to submit for the U.S., and our therapy program will hopefully before the end of the year start phase three clinical trials, which is the last stage in development of a clinical product.
You've got a U.S. commercial distribution agreement in place, have you?
We've got a number, actually. So as our product gets towards commercial stage, and in fact, we are already making that product available, you know, under compassionate use and various sort of special access protocols. We actually delivered prostate imaging to about 11,500 patients around the globe last year. So we're well and truly a commercial stage company, but the real commercial momentum for a product comes when you get that final regulatory approval from either the Food and Drug Administration in the U.S. or European competent authorities. So we're in that final push now to get those approvals, and which we expect around the middle of next year. And then that opens up about an $850 million US dollar opportunity for our prostate imaging agent. So a very significant commercial opportunity for the company.
And what else needs to be done as you prepare for market launch?
I mean, look, it's for as a company going from an R&D stage company to a commercial stage company, we're effectively rewiring the entire company right now. But, building sales teams, building distribution partner networks. In some countries, we take a more frontline involvement. In some countries, we rely more heavily on distributors. We currently are able to reach about 60 countries around the globe with our supply chain. So, obviously not all countries have the same focus. But yes, it's a very active time in terms of becoming that commercial stage revenue-generating company.
And as far as your kidney program, you say you've got two antibodies. One of them's in phase three.
Correct. So, well, our renal cancer renal cancer imaging product is just completing a phase three trial, or it's in the process of executing a phase three trial. We expect that will enroll its last patients around the end of Q1 of next year. And then it'll take about another quarter for that trial to read out. So I think shareholders would expect to see that by the middle of next year, we'd have the second product fully baked, so to speak. We just got breakthrough designation for that product in the United States by the FDA, which means that we've been able to demonstrate that it has a meaningful, addresses an unmet medical need, so to speak. And so that will be a relatively accelerated pathway to market. And we would expect that we would submit for approval for that second product by the end of next year.
And is the glioblastoma program, is that in the clinic or is that preclinical?
No. All of we don't have any preclinical. So we're definitely treating two-legged patients, not four-legged ones these days. So our glioblastoma product is in early clinical development in a phase 1/2 trial. It's recruiting at various sites in Europe and Australia. We expect to have a first data readout on that by the end of the year. It's an open label trial. When we treat patients with glioblastoma, it's such an aggressive disease, we don't do randomized blinded trials because you're not dealing with a patient that's got a lot of time to live. So we know that we're already getting exciting data from that program, and really looking forward to have the first major summary of the performance of that product by the end of the year.
How's the balance sheet?
So we're a well-funded company. We've got about $30 million on the balance sheet, which is enough to get us through to about September of next year, including the market launch costs of our prostate imaging product, our first product. We can stretch it out to the end of the year if need be. We've sifted our capital very carefully during COVID because, like many biotech companies, in a non-pandemic area of drug development, we've had to scale back clinical trials, and we've had a hiatus. We've done a lot of other useful things, of course, in that time, but clinical trials has been, has been a struggle in the pandemic. So we don't expect to raise capital this year. In fact, we've expressly given guidance that we will not be raising capital this year, and have sufficient funds to make it through, particularly with the $11.4 million R&D tax credit that we just got back. We've got enough cash to make it through our first product launch and get to cash generation. So really an inflection point for the company in terms of our capital markets interaction as well.
And what about the management team? What experience have they got when it comes to bringing new products to market?
Look, we've got a stellar team with a lot of experience in market launch. We built out the bench strength in a lot of key areas, medical and regulatory affairs. We've got a cracking head of sales and marketing now in the U.S. and in Europe with 20 years or plus, more than 20 years of experience in product launch in these areas. So, and plus the partners that we've got on board are, extremely dominant partners in the territories that they serve. And we already have a track record of working with them. We're already delivering product through those distribution networks. So, but your question is a good one. I mean, I think a lot of investors, underestimate what's required of a company going from, running clinical trials to actually selling a product. We sold, as I said before, almost 12,000 doses last year. We missed three doses for the year. We're starting to work at a level where we're able to clearly demonstrate to the market, to the industry that we operate in, that we're a serious player and that we are delivering product all around the globe.
Chris, good to meet you. Thanks very much for your time.
Thanks for your time, Andrew. Appreciate it.